Hey everybody, welcome to Always on Liberty. I'm Dan, and you are?
Lisa!
Tonight we're going to talk to you about a few things that we've figured out over the last 5 years. So grab your favorite, 5 o'clock somewhere, get comfortable, and we'll be right back to tell you a few tips that we've come up with.
Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button up in the corner.
Hey, before we get started, a quick shout out to some friends of ours, Chuck and Michelle Crow. They are the band Status Crows. If you ever get the chance to go to one of their shows, it's more than worth your time.
In the past 5 years, we have learned some pretty important and necessary RV life skills. And some of them we've learned the hard way. So we're going to go through our five, and maybe our tips will help you. First of all, you got to have a sense of independence. You have to be able to figure out where you're going, traveling maps, how to figure out apps.
A lot of this isn't predetermined. You'll have to figure it out for yourself, where you want to go, what you want to do, who you want to meet, and the things you want to experience. So there isn't really a strict roadmap for anybody, but it's that sense of independence that will give you the freedom and the willingness to stay on the road and continue to go that way.
Right. And it's even your everyday RV life and cooking and knowing how to find the grocery stores and knowing how to find your campgrounds and using your websites and finding your community as well.
Absolutely.
Okay, now the second thing, and you're really, really good at this, is you have to have a sense of mechanical ability, and you have to be willing to diagnose and repair and, or at least find the answers to fix our crap.
Yeah, I don't think you need to be a technical expert in any field of the RV industry. You don't need to be an expert electrician or an expert air conditioning repairman or an expert tire frame person, but you need to have a little bit of knowledge about everything and kind of be a jack of all trades, because quite often you're going to find yourself far from a dealership, far from a service center, and probably out of earshot of even a local repair guy who's probably too busy to come to your site anyways. So you're going to need a little bit of mechanical ability and some basic tools, and we've done some blog posts about the basic toolkits and things like that, but you've got to kind of troubleshoot your problems a little bit on your own. And when you do that, you'll become more confident in your abilities, and your RV will be better maintained, and you're going to have a better RVing experience.
Well, and with that, Dan, goes with read the manual. Your RV.
Manuals are your friend.
Yes. Your RV is going to come with manuals, especially if it's new. If it doesn't come with manuals, there's tons of resources out there.
Sure.
There's, you know, join the communities on social media. There's tons of Facebook groups that, you know, hone in on what your interests are on your brand of RV.
Sure.
There's owners clubs.
They are very, very helpful. A lot of those folks in the owners clubs have been in those types of RVs for years. They're very knowledgeable about every bit of the chassis, the frame, the wiring, the plumbing. They know a lot. There's a lot of information out there.
Right. Also, when you get into this whole thing called RV life, if you're brand new at it, so you don't screw up, we recommend there's 3 awesome courses out there. Our friends Brandon and Carenza give a shout out to RV to Freedom. They have a course. And there's also the Escapees, the RV University.
Yep, RV University.
Yep. And our friends Julie and Mark from RV Love, who have the RV Successful. And on our blog, we put the web addresses and how to get to those links. But, you know, take a course.
Sure.
You might spend a little bit of money, but, you know, if you don't spend it now, you're going to spend it later.
Sure.
In a repair or an oh crap moment.
And knowledge is power, and that is going to improve and enhance your RV experience. And it's going to make a less stressful event for you on moving days and any day, anytime you're doing anything with your RV.
Right.
If you follow those that simple rule, it will make your life a lot easier in the RV world.
Right. Okay. Number three. This is something we learned when we were in the military. Improvise, overcome, and adapt. And everybody can do this. When you downsize from a sticks and bricks house, you're going to learn really, really quick on the downsizing process. We don't call them growing pains, we call them shrinking pains.
It is a shrinking pain.
Yes, it is. And as a matter of fact, we're sitting right in front of our third RV. And we went from a 42-foot fifth wheel to right. 25 feet.
It's a monster. It's huge. Huge.
And it's been a process.
Oh, it's been
so,
a process.
So right. We've had to learn how to improvise using the things we already had.
Right.
We had to overcome some hurdles. We're trying to figure out the solar system in the energy management to make this equal, if not better, to than our fifth wheel did, so we can go out there and moondog. And then we need to adapt. And this also goes along with our relationship,
sure.
because we are in a much smaller RV, and wow.
You better like each other a lot, because I'm telling you, we live in a very small RV. It's 25 feet, 8 inches. It's one room. So quite often you may be unclothed in front of one another near the dining room table, maybe near the refrigerator.
Naked and afraid?
Naked and afraid. Seriously, but that is RV life. A lot of RVs are very small. They're small travel trailers, smaller motorhomes, things like that. That is just a fact of life, and it's something you have to be comfortable with. And improvise, overcome, and adapt, that's not just a line from a Clint Eastwood movie. That's how you need to look at your life as an RVer. You've got to be able to do those three things very well.
Right, right. Okay, now number four, this could be controversial a little bit because we all have different standards in life, but it goes along with the self-pride thing.
Sure.
And I'm going to give you a good example. Don't be that guy at the campground when you set all your stuff up and it looks like Walmart at Christmas time. Everything's strewn everywhere. Have a little pride and keep your RV space tidy outside.
Sure.
Make it welcoming, actually, for people to come see you.
Sure. Keep your site clean. Obey the rules of the campground if you're in a campground. If you're out boondocking on BLM land, be very nice to the ecology out there and the environment. I mean, it is truly a gift and a pleasure to be able to use those places. Take good care of the environment. Be a good steward for the RV community, because you don't want to be that guy that leaves a big pile of trash or has some sort of issue that's going to give the rest of the RVers a bad name.
Right. And with that, you know, use your community. The RV community out there is absolutely wonderful. And when you first start out, you might have a little hard time trying to get out there and finding your little niche, a group of people that you kind of blend with. It took us a good year, actually, because our first year, we were like, go, go, go.
Actually, it took Lisa the first year. I was out shaking hands and kissing babies and running for mayor of every campground and every RV park we were in for the first year. I would go out to take the trash out and come back an hour later because I got caught in a conversation with somebody at the waterfill or at the dump station or just in life, about life in general or about RVs. I think you need to be very outgoing. You need to be approachable.
Right.
You need to approach other people. Don't be so shy that you can't approach somebody to ask them if they like the hitch that's in their truck. Do you like your Ford? Do you like your Dodge? Do you like your fifth wheel? Do you like your motorhome? Approach people and ask them, where's the best place you've been? Do you like a certain type of climate? There's a lot of information out there if you're willing to approach people and if you're willing to be open enough to be approached.
Right, right. So that was number four. Now number five, I think, is the most important.
You better have a sense of humor. You better have a sense of humor in this life, because at some point you're just gonna look at each other and go, what the F was that?
And it's a no-brainer. Crap is going to break. Your RV is going to break. Your dishes are going to fly out of the cabinet.
You will make a wrong turn, be stuck at a dead end, be going, holy cow, what did I just do?
Or the GPS took us the wrong way. Oh my goodness. We don't have enough fingers and toes. We admit we've made some pretty outlandish mistakes.
And you have to look at everything with a sense of humor. And if you do, I'm not saying make light of every situation you're in, because some are serious and you need to take them seriously. But reflect and look back and approach things with a sense of humor. And if you do that, you're going to be much happier. It's like the guy that goes to play golf on Saturday. He's not Tiger Woods. If he goes out there thinking he's going to shoot a 68, I got news for you. If you break 100, buddy, you're probably better than some of the other golfers on the course on Saturday morning. You can't expect to be a PGA golfer if you only play once a week. It's ridiculous. And it's like that in the RV world. You just got to have a sense of humor and go with it. We're all kind of just going along in life.
Yeah, you have to laugh at yourself. And there's some situations, share those stories, because there's going to always be that one RVer that they think that they've done the worst. Oh no.
Hold my beer.
So
let me share one of those situations with you real quick.
Oh God,
here we go. We talk every now and then about the importance of having an RV GPS or a trucker's atlas and knowing what route you're going to be on. But every now and then, things happen and you get off the route that you intend to be on. So Lisa and I are driving in the mountains of Virginia one day, hauling a 44-foot toy hauler.
Yeah, this is when we had our fifth wheel toy hauler with the motorcycles.
Quite a large unit to be pulling with a 1-ton dually truck. And the route's been calculated almost down to the mile, and we're cruising along, and we're lost all of a sudden. And we're not just lost, we're lost for about 35 miles in the mountains of Virginia, on some country roads, some back roads, headed for Pocahontas State Park.
Well, first of all, we do need to let you know that that was within our first year.
It was within the first year without
a doubt. And guess who did not have an RV GPS?
We did not have an RV GPS. We did not have a trucker's atlas or a motor carrier's atlas. We had Google Maps and that was about it.
And guess what else we did? We didn't have enough gas.
Didn't have enough diesel fuel. So we're driving along and all of a sudden I see this sign. Low clearance, 13.6. And Lisa says, hey, those numbers mean something. And I said, yes, honey, they do. That's the height of the fifth wheel. And I never let off the fuel. And Lisa's in the passenger side getting under the dash, rubbing rosary beads and saying and Hail Marys.
I'm praying, don't sleep, baby Jesus.
I said, honey, you better hope that they haven't resurfaced this road, because 13.6 is the height of the air conditioner. So we're about to take all three air conditioners off that fifth wheel back there. Fortunately, we made it through. No problem.
But we can laugh about it now.
We can laugh about it
and
now.
And we tell that story so others learn from us and don't make that mistake.
So we finally get to Pocahontas State Park. Lisa goes into the ranger station to check us in, tells them what road we came down, and the ranger looks at her and says, are you nuts?
There's an exit 3 miles away.
Nobody comes down that road. So after that experience, the first thing we did is we went to the local pilot station and we bought a motor carrier's atlas to make sure the roads we were going to be on we're approved for tractor trailers and rigs the size of ours.
Yeah.
So that's just a helpful hint, you know, with a little bit of humor to help you understand how important some of these things are.
Yeah. So those are your 5 RV skills you really, really do need to have. Even if you've been out on the road, if you're a beginner, newbie, or if you've been out there for years, as long as you keep those 5 necessary RV tips and skills in the back of your mind always, guess what? You're going to roll on and you're going to have the time of your life.
So that's it for tonight. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and tune into the channel.
Yeah, and tune in next time. What are we going to talk about next?
We don't know, but you know what? It'll be our point of view. I can guarantee you that.
All right, see you next time.